consider another common kitchen item, a piece of nonstick cookware. Now, this nonstick material has worked its way into 95% of the human population, but it's kept pancakes, eggs, and vegetables from sticking to the pan for decades. It's a $2 billion a year industry, and a piece of nonstick cookware is found in almost every American household. It's been considered the apotheosis, the most magnificent manifestation of better cooking through chemistry. But is it? Nonstick surfaces are made of complicated chemical compounds, polytetrafluoroethylene, PTFE, and perfluorooctanoic acid, PFOA. Every time we use a nonstick pan, we're cooking with these chemical ingredients. Besides nonstick pans, perfluorooctanoic acid, which is a kind of plastic, is also used in aerospace, in automotive parts, in cleaning supplies, in communications, in architecture, electronics. I mean, this stuff is everywhere, including inside us. Perfluorooctanoic acid is now found in the blood of 95% of all Americans. Our good friend, the lab rat, tells us that perfluorooctanoic acid is a likely human carcinogen and may cause organ damage and birth defects. Because of this, major manufacturers of nonstick surfaces have agreed to stop using PFOAs by 2010, and the hope is that no one will use PFOA for anything after 2015.
Well, so what are we supposed to do with these things?
Well, you cook with it, but it is a slippery question. This one's in great shape, though. Look at that. It's smooth. Its surface is intact. But if you have one like this, where the surface is beaten up and scratched, blemished, well, you don't want to cook with it, because that means some of this plastic material has ended up inside of some of us, and that's not good. Someone failed to use a plastic utensil when cooking with this. I'll tell you what else. Don't let these cooking things overheat, because the chemicals can end up in the air, and then they can end up inside of you or even your pets, and that can't be good. Now, if you have one that's beaten up like this, you can recycle it. It's made of aluminum, or it has an aluminum core, so someone could make a little cash on one of these. Now, if you have to use nonstick cookware, think about an alternative nonstick surface like ceramic, or even, dare I say it, good old-fashioned, well-seasoned cast iron. These things last forever, and they cook very well. And let me tell you, if you hit someone over the head with one of these, probably be the last thing that ever happened to them. If nothing else, we spend a lot of time in the kitchen. We've got running water and all manner of spillable foodstuffs, so stuff is bound to happen. Reduce your food waste, reuse your grocery transportation equipment, and watch your polytetrafluoroethylene. Remember, everything we do in the kitchen affects the environment all over the world. Now, all of this might seem like common sense, and it is. But as my mother and father often pointed out, common sense is just not that common.